I'm Cristina Roman. I'm the lead pharmacist at the Alfred Emergency and Trauma Centre. I've been working in the emergency department for almost 12 years. I've established all of the ED pharmacy services across Alfred Health and have really enjoyed being involved in this area of practice, which is a very exciting place to work. I've previously been working at the Alfred in general clinical roles. And then I got the senior position in the emergency department to establish the pharmacy services there. So there was previously no pharmacy services to the emergency department. And through my involvement in patient care in the emergency department and also investigation of other models of care across other countries, including in the US, I was able to establish that there was a gap in how we practice in Australia, particularly around involvement in critically unwell patients.
Thrombolytic therapy is used in ischaemic strokes. So an ischaemic stroke is where we have a clot blocking a blood vessel in the brain, stopping blood flow to that area. And this causes brain tissue to die. So thrombolytic therapy, known as tissue plasminogen activators, so we use alteplase or tenecteplase, this binds to the clot in the blood vessel in the brain and effectively dissolves the clot so that we can get blood reperfusing in that area to save any salvageable brain tissue. And as we know, time is brain. So for every minute that there is a blood clot in the brain obstructing flow to an area of the brain, we've got risk of the brain tissue dying. And this can be permanent and cause permanent disability to our patients. So time is brain. So it means we need to get the thrombolytic therapy, if the patient's eligible for it, as soon as possible.
We're getting pharmacists involved at the very point of arrival of the most critically unwell patients coming into the ED. So this includes both patients presenting as a result of an injury from a motor car accident, or it could be motorbikes or trucks or any other injuries, but also patients presenting unwell with medical conditions such as heart attacks, strokes, and sepsis. And their main role is to help contribute to upfront decision making around medicines. So this might involve taking a rapid medication history, understanding what medicines patients are taking at home, but also helping to advise on the best medicines to use when the patient first comes in. These patients are usually requiring many medications at the same time, as well as many other interventions at the same time. So all of this puts a lot of stress on the medical team and nursing staff to be able to do all of this at the same time. So the pharmacist at the bedside helps to make those decisions about medicine specifically, making sure that we're giving the right medication to the patient in front of us, and that we're also administering it in an appropriate way. So through my research, I've established that having pharmacists as part of stroke calls, where pharmacists are involved on arrival of a patient with an ischemic stroke, we can help to improve door-to-needle time, which is the time from arrival of a patient to the time they receive thrombolysis, which is a clot-busting medication that can be given to some patients if they're eligible, which helps to improve long-term morbidity on discharge. So with that particular medication, thrombolysis, there are a lot of factors that come into the decision-making around whether someone is appropriate for thrombolysis. So having pharmacists involved, we can also not only identify patients that might be appropriate for thrombolysis, but we can also chart the thrombolysis, as well as other medicines associated with thrombolysis, such as blood pressure medicines, and also help the nurses with administering thrombolysis, which can be a high-risk medicine and also a challenge to administer if you're not familiar with it. Another example which I've recently published is around pharmacist involvement in sepsis calls. We know that sepsis is common, it has a high mortality, and the only evidence-based treatment at the moment for sepsis, particularly for patients that are severely unwell with sepsis, which we call septic shock, is early antibiotic treatment. So in my study, which was a retrospective cohort comparing pre and post involvement of pharmacists in sepsis calls, I've established that having pharmacists involved in sepsis calls, particularly for patients that need ICU care, So the most unwell patients, improves time to antibiotic administration. And that's really because pharmacists can be there on arrival, helping to make the right decision about which antibiotic is appropriate, but also helping to chart that antibiotic and helping the nurses to draw it up. So it improves time to antibiotic administration, which recently has been part of the national quality standards for sepsis, where we want to give antibiotics early, particularly in the septic shock group of patients. My third chapter of my PhD was looking at pharmacists in trauma calls, and this was a randomized study that I'm about to publish, again, showing the value of having pharmacists involved early on in patient care, so contributing to time to early analgesia administration and also many other medicines that patients may need on arrival when they're coming in with severe injuries from road trauma or other types of injuries.
The results of the study included 218 patients, with 64 patients included in the pre-implementation and 122 patients in the post-implementation. The results of the study showing decreased door to thrombolysis time, so that's the time that the patient arrives to hospital to receiving thrombolysis. The study by Cristina Roman showed a significant decrease in this door to needle time, meaning that pharmacist involvement in stroke call-out teams means faster thrombolysis to our patients where eligible. From an Alfred point of view, this has impacted the daily emergency medicine pharmacist role. We now attend every stroke call out within pharmacy working hours, and we're there right at the bedside as part of the stroke call out team with a critical care nurse, the stroke registrar, the ED registrar, and we all work together efficiently to ensure that the patient gets the best treatment in the quickest way possible.
The redesign changes as part of the stroke study, sepsis and trauma. The main thing we had to look at was how can we upskill the pharmacists that we had working in the emergency department to make sure that they are providing a standardized service when they are attending these trauma, sepsis or stroke calls so that they can maximize the benefit as part of the team. So I developed a credentialing package for each of these roles and made sure that pharmacists were confident with what their role was and how they could maximize their benefit as part of the team. The other aspect was ensuring that we had medical and nursing support, which was actually very easy to get because the nurses and the medical staff were actually asking us to be involved and they were pulling us into these scenarios, and that's why we came about formalizing these programs for pharmacists to attend every single time there was a sepsis or a stroke or a trauma call. And this just helps to standardize what we do across the time that we are working in the emergency department. Pharmacists are now increasingly being involved in upfront decision making around medicines on arrival of patients coming in, particularly for critically unwell patients. So what we've found now is that pharmacists are basically attending all critically unwell patients in the emergency department. This is beyond sepsis, stroke and trauma. It could be for STEMI patients, it could be for any patient that's coming in that's severely injured or unwell. It's also extended to a lot of interest across other emergency departments, both in Victoria, but also nationally and internationally. And this model of care originally came from the US. And I had a number of ideas from visiting trauma centres in the US and seeing what pharmacists do there. And so this model has now got a lot of interest to be implemented both in New Zealand and in Europe. And I do think that there's a lot of advantages to having pharmacists involved very early on in the patient journey. And so because of that, we've found that many other emergency departments are emailing and asking to visit and how they can practically start to get involved in these kind of patients. So there's a lot of interest. There's also other research going on. So I do know of two other PhDs looking at this specific area of practice. And I just think this is an area that's really expanding very rapidly. And we're only going to see more and more of pharmacists involved in this kind of area of practice.